So hi guys, welcome to my third vlog. And in this vlog, I took upon myself to learn Unity in one day and build a game. But it took me one day just to get accustomed to how things work in Unity, 2D and 3D things. So on Saturday, I thought I'll build a game in 3D, and it took me like 5 hours to learn how you manage to build terrains and all that. So I couldn't build this on Saturday. So I thought maybe on Sunday I can build this game. So I wake up on Sunday and I realize that today is a Kickstart challenge. So guys, for some context, Google Kickstart is a challenge that occurs every other month. And in this, you have like 4 questions that you have to answer. And if you answer all of them in record time, like there are some perks for that. So that's what Kickstart is about. So guys, this is my first Kickstart this year, and I had given one in December, but I couldn't get any question right. This time I was positive that I may be able to solve one question, reason being I had been solving some complicated questions, and I had that confidence that maybe this time I could do one. And record breaker problem was easy. Like I was almost able to solve the question. Like for the sample test cases, I was getting the right output. I even checked 10 times if I'm getting those, if they're right or not. But there is one thing that I did wrong. I even read it on FAQs that maybe if you're doing everything fine and if it's still not working, then you should with a new approach. I didn't try. I should have just removed all my code and should have tried again, but no, I was adamant that man, this is right and it should work. Like I was so furious. Like it was like I was like Kaioken times 4 angry. So that question didn't work. I was able to submit that question. Like I was really sad, but my friend suggested that I should just move on to next question, maybe that will work. So next question was alien problem, and when I read the question, I was 50% sure I'm not gonna solve this, because I know how I can, I know the approach that I can take to solve it, but since I couldn't solve record breaker, like my confidence was a bit down. So anyways, I tried that question and it wasn't working, and I feel like banging my head on the keyboard. So I was depressed that day, but I didn't give up. That evening I tried this question again and I was able to solve this question. At that time I felt a different emotion, guys. I was both happy and sad at the same time. Sad because I couldn't solve this question like few hours back, because it would have meant more because I would gain those points and not a zero. So that was about Sunday, and that's why this Unity challenge was postponed to Monday, and I couldn't do it on Monday because I had exams. So I do it on Tuesday. So Tuesday I planned, like I will make this game on Tuesday, and this is what happened, guys. So guys, the original idea about creating this game was I'll make an unfair archer. The game was about an archer that will shoot arrows and hit a certain target. But when he's hitting target, a object will appear that will stop the arrow sometimes and sometimes not. So it's a random game, like it's completely based on luck that it will either hit a target or not, no matter how precise you are, because there's gonna be some difficulty while hitting on the target, because it's not gonna be like in the front of the person. So that was a game that is going to depend on both skill and luck. That was what I wanted to build. The game, I even thought about title, like Unfair Archer. Like it started off good, like I'll get to learn about how different things work, about how we manage game objects, how there are different layers and hierarchies. Like those things were easy. But then I come to learn that I have to do scripting, and I know nothing about C#, so I have to look up a lot of videos. Like without those YouTube videos, this I couldn't have gone that far, that I would have been able to move the particular object. Like I don't know how C# work and how you actually move the objects. So a huge shout out to them. So I learned a bit about how you manage to move the objects and all, how you're able to jump those objects, how physics works. Like that was surprising for me, like you have to use those things, like there are buoyancies for object that are floating so that they won't like suppress some, like, I'll actually add some bloopers in behind the scene that you can see, like, when I created a floating object, floating ground on this screen, it was because of the gravity, it was suppressing the player downwards. And then I come to know that I have to add gravity buoyancy in it, then it was looking fine. So, few things that I learned here and there, and surprising and fun. So, I started by animating it, and the assets that I downloaded came with a lot of sprites so that I can just create the animations. And it worked out fine so far, but then comes the worst part. Like, I wanted to have a dart, but I couldn't have the dart because I cannot download it from asset store, because like it was showing that it downloading, but it doesn't show the, like, it was just like downloading 0% and then it stopped. Like, it was like really 3 megabyte file and it was downloading. So a lot of things went wrong in that day. So I ended up deciding that I will just take another archer from that asset that I downloaded. So, also, it was cool to have, like, to be able to animate things, even though I didn't draw these things, but it was still a lot of fun. How you can create like hit animations, and although they already came with this, but I created them myself just to learn how this works. And stop the arrow target. So that was the original idea of the game, but I couldn't download the dart assets, so I stick with just having another archer that I'm gonna hit. So also, I couldn't download the arrow, so I have to download from Google, and as you can see, it's not what I planned. So I watched a lot of videos and how it works, like I actually pin a video here that how I was so desperate about, because the arrow has to be appeared as I play, as I shoot it. So it should appear and then disappear, so, you know, like destroying the object. I watched those videos, I know how it works. So, but at that time, in a span of 24 hours, I couldn't get everything done, and it was like an epic fail. So I don't know when this video is gonna go live, but I will just say that if you are new to something, you should give it some time, because it's really difficult to difficult to learn a game in just a span of like 24 hours. It's really small. So that's what I want to say in this vlog. Like, it was an epic fail, and hope I see you in my next vlog. Thanks for watching.